Yo, 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 welcome to episode 4 of the Iron, and we are starting this off doing a little DKs, killing my man Rex because he drops, you know, that juicy berserker ring, and I'm trying to get max bonus as soon as possible. With that said, kill number 1, do we get the... No, we do not, but moments later we get the Dragon Axe, which is a really good drop to get because obviously you can only get it from here or Winter Todd. And I don't like Winter Todd, so we got the Dragon Axe out of the way, checking it off the list. So I mentioned last episode, I have to start doing a lot more quests because obviously I'm a 42 defense count. I need Barrow's Gloves, and I also need to finish off this 43 prayer because it's taken so long. So here I am finishing up another prayer quest, and it's actually going to give me 243. So this will actually be the last prayer quest that I'm going to be doing. At least that's the plan. Rum deal complete, and we are also 60 farming. We can use the UCs that we have in the bank. And with rum deal, I actually am one step closer to doing the quest for Black Mass, which is going to be pretty near in the future here. I've not been minding doing a few quests, so here we are completing Temple of Ikov, which is a requirement for Desert Treasure, and Desert Treasure is also a requirement for Recipe for Disaster. So kind of just banging them out and getting them done. I'm going to start Recipe for Disaster next, just because kind of want to see where I'm at as far as subquests go. So since I'm questing like a madman recently, figured we'd start doing the Recipe for Disaster. So started off with the Dwarf, and the reason for this is that way I can actually imbue my Berserker Ring, because the Rock Cake is really useful for Nightmare Zone. Coming in with another one of the RFD subquests completed. Basically, right now, I'm just doing as many of them as I can, and if I don't have the requirements, I'm working towards getting those requirements, because I would love to get Barrow's Gloves in this episode, so we're grinding as hard as we can to get that done. And there we go, Pirate Pete is now complete. Wow, that was a mouthful right there, but with that, we can now actually do seaweed runs, and I'm going to start doing as much seaweed as I can, because, yeah, giant seaweed is actually really OP. And it's also really good to start doing with the birdhouse runs. I forgot how easy these RFD like subquests are. I think I've done maybe 3 or 4 in under an hour. It's insanely fast. I really don't know why I've put it off so long. Here we are with Horror from the Deep completed. We are closing in on 175 quest points. A juicy 2 quest points from this one, as well as some good XP. And we are approaching 175 sooner than I would have imagined. Gonna move on to the Evil Dave one now, and I honestly have never been lucky with this one. It's always taken me at least 20 minutes, so hopefully that is not the case this time, but you know, you never know, it's kinda RNG based. Just as I figured, took frickin' like 30 minutes. Look at all these damn stews in my inventory. Yeah, not happy about that, but finally, the Evil Dave is complete. I believe we have 1 or 2 left. I'm gonna do the monkey one next, and we're actually gonna have to boost to cook it. So kind of good thing we got these stews out of the way early on here. All right, we got 3 of the snake things to cook, and we only have about 3 chances here to get the boost. So it is a little nerve-wracking. I was not sure if I was actually going to get it or not, because as you can see, it came down to the wire. We legitimately had one more shot at this, and luckily I got the boost. And with 3 chances, yeah, it was a little sketchy, so we actually ended up cooking every one of them, and finally we can complete this subquest, and we are nearly done with the Barrow Gloves grind. With that subquest out of the way, we are now going to do Desert Treasure, and I have like a nice little tip for doing the Caniphus boss, so I'm going to show you guys that, because it's extremely useful if you have prayer, because it's basically a way to safe spot the boss. All you have to do is swap your prayer from range to melee, just in a simultaneous fashion, and it confuses the boss so much that he just doesn't attack you. So yeah, really useful to use, especially for low level Ironmen. As you can see, I only ate a few times, but that's just kind of my bad because I fucked it up, but really easy boss, and we are now going to be finishing Desert Treasure finally. With Desert Treasure complete, we now have 175 quest points. It is time to take on the RFD bosses, and I have not done these in a really long time, and when I did, it was on like a maxed out account. So yeah, I actually don't know how difficult it's gonna be. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, this probably took about 30 minutes to kill all the bosses. I was basically testing different methods. Ivan's Blast wasn't really working out, and Melee really wasn't either, but we got it completed, and honestly, this is a huge achievement for the account. I'm really happy to get this out of the way because we are now basically set up for the future as far as everything goes for PVMing, because we have Barrow's Gloves unlocked, and might as well go buy them right now. There we are. God, they look so sick. Absolutely insane. I never actually thought I'd get this far with the account, so Barrow's Gloves achieved. Now all I have left basically is for now a Fire Cape, Berserker Ring, and later on a Fury, which will turn into a torture end game. But I think I want to go back to Rex because we need that Berserker Ring. But we certainly do not need these stupid rock shell legs. It's like the same drop rate, I believe, as the rings, which is quite unfortunate because you'll see, but I get a shit ton of these. With the RFD chest completely unlocked, I figured I could make a lot of pineapple pizzas because, you can buy all the supplies basically in the chest. So here we are, kind of just testing out the method. You can bank all this stuff pretty quick, and it's okay cooking XP. I think it's like 200 per pineapple pizza. As far as the whole process goes, but yeah, I thought I'd make a lot of these because it heals 22 HP per pizza, and it could be really good to bring to Rex and probably some other bosses in the future as well. If you do this method as well, I'd strongly recommend buying out the grapes. It stocks up around like 7, I believe, and yeah, you can just slowly bank a lot of cooking XP. So yeah, it's really useful just to do while you're buying the other supplies. I want to say this whole process is probably taking maybe 20 to 30 minutes just for like 200 pineapple pizzas. So, yeah, I really don't know if that's worth it, but we have at least a lot of food now to go do quite a few Rex kills, which hopefully we're not going to be there for too long. About 70 kills since our last Dragon X. We get another one. Not really too happy about that. We're approaching 100 KC. We're not dry yet for the Berserker Ring, but yeah, two Dragon Axes, not ideal. We need to start doing these giant seaweed runs as soon as possible. So I'm just high elking, waiting for the giant seaweed spawns, the spores, because it spawns like 1 to 3, pretty randomly. So just kind of multitasking. Actually, I had no idea this is a thing, but you can apparently get unicorn horns the same way you do red spider eggs at the Tower of Life. And I'm trying to get quite a lot of herb XP, and I have a lot of herbs in the bank that need these unicorn horns. So we're gonna try this method out. It shouldn't be too bad because I know the red spider egg method is really good. So yeah, just giving this a go. I don't know if you knew this method, just let me know in the comments because I had no idea. I swear, like up until now, I've literally just been killing unicorns in like Varrok, two at a time, and then hopping worlds, and not ideal. So let's see how many we get. Two, okay. I mean, not bad. I think it's the same as the red spider eggs, kind of random, and also depends on your diary. But you should probably get maybe 2 to 5 per. So still gonna be a lot quicker than just manually killing them. As mentioned earlier, more rock shell eggs. Yeah, our luck is it's going to the shitter. It is not going too hot. I tried so hard to get that kill and it just didn't happen. I don't know why I wasn't whacking it with the Ivan staff, looking at it back at it now, but damn. Ring of Life, same chances of getting the Berserker Ring. Really, really awesome. This is my first time doing one of these hardwood runs, and it's been, I think, like 3 days it takes, like 72 hours to grow. But goddamn, look at that XP. It is ridiculous. We are trying to do as much farming as we can, and like, wow, come on now. It is done. 200 KC B ring on the dot. It's only taken like 2 days, 3 days, probably 2 mil. Oh man, I'm really glad to be done with this grind. And we will come back later for the other rings. We're gonna end the video probably right about here. 59 Hunter. Hope you guys have enjoyed the series so far. If you did, make sure you drop a comment, drop a like, maybe a sub if you're not already, just so you can see the future videos in your sub box. And yeah, we are just getting started. Barrow's Clubs and Berserker Ring both unlocked this episode. We're becoming a beast. See you in the next one.